Hello friends, Rajvinder here to talk with you or discuss with you regarding the next topic, that is delegation. First of all, I would like to discuss with you about the definition of delegation. What is the delegation? It simply means to assign the work to the team. Okay? Is it transfer of responsibility for performance of a task from one person to another? That is delegation. Okay? Achieving performance of care outcomes for which you are accountable and responsible by sharing activities with other individuals who have the appropriate authority to accomplish the work. Accountability means the person, this person responsible for that particular work. Okay? When someone or our boss assign us a task, we are fully responsible for that task. Right? Then delegation, if we talk about the delegation triangle, it is responsibility, control, and authority. These three things running side by side. These three things equally important in this triangle. Then next is principles of delegation. There are total four principles that guide for effective delegation. The first one is assignment of duties according to expected results, or it is also assigned to the person who are capable to complete that task. The next one, there should be equality of authority and responsibility while assigning duties to subordinates. Do not become a partial or impartial, equally distribute the work with subordinates. Then third one, clarification of limits of authority. There are some limits set by the higher authority. Then the next one is unit of command. Command should receive from one superior only. Otherwise, it becomes hodgepodge. Then, there are some strategies for effective delegation that are plan ahead. Before the delegation of the work, you must have plan. Okay? Then, identify necessary skills and levels. You can identify the skills and level of your staff. Accordingly, you can distribute the work. Then select most capable person. Communicate goal clearly with them. Then empower, delegate. After that, set deadlines and monitor progress. When you assign the work, give the deadline, give the last date to complete the task. And in between, you can monitor the progress. Evaluate performance, then reward accomplishment. At the end, when the staff or when the team successful, then also give the reward to them in the form of good word, in the form of incentive or anything. Then, task identified. Are you the only one who can perform this task? If no, then delegate it. Delegate the work in between the team. And if you are only one to perform the task, then do it by yourself. After that, why there is a need for delegation? Delegation is very necessary. Nobody do individually anything. If we do the work with team, that will be more progressive as compared to the individual work. That's it. That's why delegation is important. In this, increase equity of patients, then increased RN responsibilities in the management of the nursing unit or organization, accelerated pace, and changing healthcare environment. These points or these delegations related to the hospital, when we provide the care to the patient in the hospital, that time these delegations are needed. Then, the five rights of delegation. What are right task? One that is delegable for specific patient. Right task means the team member capable to do the work accordingly, assign them. right circumstances, appropriate patient setting, available resources you have. Then right person. Right person is delegating the right tasks, right task, right tasks to right person to be performed in the right person. Okay? If someone know about the procedure like CPR, then you can delegate the main role of that person along with the subordinates, and they can perform on the patient who need the CPR. Okay? Then right direction and communication, clear, concise description of the task including objective, limits and expectations. Then the fifth one is right supervision, appropriate monitoring, evaluation, intervention as needed. These are the five rights. Then delegation process. Under this, first of all, you have to define the task. Then decide on the delegate. After that, determine the task, then reach an agreement, monitor performance and provide the feedback at the end. The next one is common delegation error. There are three kinds: under delegating, over delegating, improperly delegating. Under delegating means the person who are the head of the team give the work to the subordinate less than the required. Over delegation, all work given to the subordinate. Improperly, they don't know which person who have weaknesses or strength regarding that particular task. Under delegating, lack of experience, lack of trust, fear of subordinates, means do not have trust on the subordinate. Then over delegation, poor management of time, feel insecure in their ability to perform a task, the work or the task more than the capability, that is over delegation. Then the next one is improperly delegating, when the person delegate the work or task at the wrong time to the wrong person or for the wrong reason, that is the improperly delegating. Then the next one is delegating to unlicensed assistive personnel. For example, it is very mandatory to assign the work in the hospital or in the ward to the staff nurses who have completed their diploma or degree or licensed by the government. If we delegate the work to the personnel who do not know about the nursing, who do not have the license, then it is useless. Okay, no task may be delegated to unlicensed personnel that requires substantial knowledge or technical skills in this. Then pre-procedure assessment is necessary. Invasive lines, sterile technique or procedure to patient, nursing process, patient triage. If the person have a license, then he or she must know about these things. Otherwise, unlicensed person do not know the right technique. The next one is subordinate resistance to delegation. Some people do not take the responsibility or resist to complete the task or resist to delegate the work. We can discuss in this. Some subordinates resist delegation simply because they believe they are incapable of completing the task. They do not have confidence on them. Inherent resistance to authority. They have a habit to resist on anything or everything. It is an ongoing leadership challenge to instill a team spirit between delegator and subordinates. Okay? Then the next one is barriers to delegation. There are some barriers also present here. The belief that I can do it myself. Some people do not delegate the work. They always think about they can do the work by only without involving the team. Okay? Lack of confidence and trust to workers. There is also big issue in delegation when the boss do not know anything about the task and totally dependent on the member, team members. Low self-confidence or insecurity. Then unclear job description, inadequate training, and lack of adequate recruitment and selection. These all are the barriers to delegation. Then the next, fear of loss of power. Some people think that if they delegate the work, if they distribute the work in the team, might be they lost the power. Okay. Then the subordinate resistance to delegation. Sometimes subordinates not obey the order. Then due to over delegation. Sometimes the person or the head delegate the work more than the requirement, more than the capability of the staff. There are some advantages of delegation. The successful delegation results to make work easier. When we do the work in a group with the team, that time we complete some task in the particular project, that time we feel easier and our task completed on time. Then the next one is improves efficiency. In this way, we can learn many things from the other and it improves our knowledge, satisfaction and efficiency. Then the next one is increases employee effectiveness. Then develops employees and ensures that right people do the right jobs. The next one, there are some disadvantages of delegation too. First one, frailty of human life and unfamiliarity with art of delegation, then incapacity of subordinates. Subordinates not capable enough to do the task. Frailty means the person think about himself or herself, means they feel incapable or do not take the risk or do not take the responsibility. Okay. Then reasons for nurses why attempted delegation fails to meet the outcome. Nurses fail to recognize and incorporate principles of effective delegation. Nurses are unwilling or unable to view delegation from perspective of the delegate. Okay, they do the task according to their own experience. They do not know about the perspective or thinking or aim of the delegate who distribute the work in the team. Okay, then the next one, conclusion of the delegation. Delegation is a powerful tool when used correctly. Can create an effective and safe environment in which staff and patients work together to achieve positive outcomes. But mind it, if delegation work or used correctly, that time it become a good tool for us. Otherwise, it is totally wastage of time. Okay. Thank you so much for your attention. I hope you have learned something from this lecture.